It is decision day at the highest court in the land. We are waiting for two major Supreme Court rulings. Among them, the battle over religious freedom and Obamacare's controversial contraception mandate as part of that law. Morning, everybody. I'm Martha McCallum here in America's Newsroom.
And good morning, Martha. I'm Eric Schon in for Bill Hemmer this morning. That decision, as you know, is the most closely watched ruling of the whole season, marking the second time Obamacare has gone before the justices.
And once again, it could all come down to this man, Chief Justice John Roberts. He could potentially be the swing vote yet again. So which way will the drama play out this time? Byron York is the chief Washington correspondent at the Washington Examiner and a Fox News contributor. Byron, good morning to you.
Good morning, Martha.
What do you expect here this morning?
Well, this case is a huge deal for the issues of religious liberty, abortion, contraception. It is not an existential threat to Obamacare. So the mandates and the exchanges and the subsidies that we've been talking about for so long will remain intact. So it doesn't threaten that part of Obamacare. What it does talk about is whether the government can force a for-profit corporation, not a religious institution, not a church, but an actual for-profit corporation to provide a service, in this case, some types of contraception that the owners of this company say violates their religious beliefs.
Yeah, as you've pointed out, there are 20 different forms of contraception that are covered under the Obamacare mandate, and they only object to four of those, which they believe can cause an abortion. So once, conception has taken place in their minds, that it would turn that around, and that is why they are so strongly opposed to these four different kinds of contraception. So are there larger ramifications if this goes Hobby Lobby's way?
Absolutely. First of all, you are right about the narrowness of this case, which is interesting because you may have heard it described as a case in which women were denied access to birth control. Hobby Lobby does not object to providing those 16 different FDA-approved contraceptives. It's just those four that they call abortifacients that they object to. But if the case is interpreted in a bigger way, there are people who worry that if Hobby Lobby wins, that in the future a for-profit corporation could say, let's say two of their employees, same sex, decided to get married. Would the company recognize that, or would it say it violated its religious beliefs? And on the other hand, if Hobby Lobby loses, the government wins, these companies worry that the government could then be able to force them to do all sorts of things, perhaps recognizing marriage or other issues that violate what they believe their freedoms under a law passed by Congress called the Religious Freedom Restoration Act.
One quick question about Chief Justice John Roberts. Obviously, conservatives were none too happy with his decision on Obamacare, a decision that he made that could have turned the whole thing around and made it unconstitutional. That was a big surprise. Do you expect any big surprises from him today?
Well, I think what we've seen from Roberts in his entire tenure as Chief Justice is an effort to try to find common ground, find agreement, and to do that by narrowing the scope of the decisions. So is there a way for the Supreme Court to narrow the scope of this decision, perhaps side with Hobby Lobby? Because we certainly thought in the oral arguments in March that some of the justices were on Hobby Lobby's side, but to side with it, but not to make it a big general principle. I think that's what I would look for Roberts to try to do.
Interesting. We will see. Just about an hour away now from when we expect to start to get these decisions rolling forward. There's a second one, too, that we're going to talk about quite a bit here this morning. Byron, thanks so much. We'll see you later.
Thank you, Martha.
So, Martha, just how will the justices rule on the Obamacare contraception mandate? And what will it mean for the future of the president's signature law? Well, we could find out in just over an hour. The Supreme Court starting its session at the top of the hour at 10 a.m. in Washington, D.C. The big decision could come down any moment right after that. And as soon as it is in our hands, we will, of course, break it all down for you with instant reaction and analysis. You know, Martha, history could be in the making.